I thought I hit a skunk on the way over here. They're doing construction next door. It looked like a skunk. It felt thumpy when I hit it. And then there was no smell, and I said, that wasn't a skunk. Has anybody ever seen this before? I hit a porcupine here in the Northwest. Yep. So I gotta pull all these porcupine. Hopefully they didn't go in far enough to give me a problem here, a leak here, right? They didn't go in too far, but yeah, there you go. It can happen. And good morning, everybody. The next 2 days that I'm going to be filming are going to include two separate installs of some major things that I think every full-time RVer is going to want to take care of at some point. And I'm actually surprised it's taken this long. But like I mentioned in my last video, I went with a different company for my cell phone booster. And that is Solid RF out of Canada here. This is not going to be like a step-by-step installation showing you every little thing, but I'm going to show you how I put this all together and how I plan it out. First, let's talk about what a cell phone booster is, because these have not been around for that long, but you're seeing more and more RVs with a big, bulky-looking antenna up on their roof, and some people think they're for TVs, some people think they're for Wi-Fi. These are cell phone boosters. Essentially, what we're doing is, instead of going directly from our phone to the cell phone tower that's really far away, we are going from our phone to this interior antenna, which goes to another module. In this case, this white one will be outside the RV. And then this big antenna is going to be up on the roof, which is going to communicate with that cell tower that's really far away. And this device is going to amplify that existing cell signal and give us a more workable cell service. So this does not magically give you cell phone service on the road if there's no tower nearby. It simply amplifies what wasn't usable into a usable cell service option. And for me, I always call it a Wi-Fi booster because I have a hotspot device that creates Wi-Fi out of my cell tower stuff from AT&T. So essentially, this will help me upload videos more regularly. It'll be a lot more dependable on the road. Plus, it'll help with Netflix, Amazon Prime, PS4 gaming with friends and stuff like that. So in a world where mostly you have to pay for every gigabyte you use a service, having a cell phone booster, a cell booster, is something you gotta have. This kit is actually quite similar to the WeBoost one. It comes with some directions, and you can see here by that little diagram, 4 feet from the internal antenna to the external antenna, and then you've got another antenna 12 feet away. So it came with this plate to screw and glue to the roof, hence the Gorilla Glue here. Then this guy gets mounted on the roof with two ports. One of them is going to be this big beefy antenna up on the roof. Then I'm going to bring some wire down through the fridge vent so they don't have to drill another hole. It's going to hook into this interior antenna right here. And then there is a secondary small antenna that goes 12 feet away somewhere else in the RV. While I would imagine the Gorilla Glue to be enough, since I do have some self-tapping screws, I am going to also drill this into the roof because it's an extrusion from the roof that I'm a little worried about. You know, if you hit a branch, although I'm really careful usually, you hit a branch hard enough, it may pull on this a little bit. So I'm gonna go up there, glue, and screw this to the roof. Okay, and we're up here on the roof. I'm not running the air conditioner, I've just got the air flowing in there because I don't want to get condensation on the roof while I'm waiting for this to dry, but I got the plate down. So that's Gorilla Glue, and you can see how it started to push out once I put in the screws. And I picked a central location for this. You want nothing nearby within 4 feet. So the middle of the RV is kind of why I put this here. But also, even though it's going to be lower than the air conditioner, this way I know if I ever feel a branch or anything hit the first air conditioner up here, I know this might hit too. Kind of my safety net right there. And the Gorilla Glue does say it needs 24 hours to fully cure. Since I'm not going to be moving for 24 hours, I'm going to let it cure, but I'm still going to start putting on the components, which means first thing I want to do is start sealing this up. So I've got my self-leveling sealant up here. I'm gonna hit all the screw holes around here. And then once I put the fridge vent back together, I'm gonna have to use this on the heads of the screws as well. Here's the solar going down behind the fridge that Wayne did And so we're gonna follow that, tap into that, and that way I don't have to drill another hole anywhere into the roof.
So I'm putting together the mounting spot for the antenna, and one thing I just noticed, see this spring stuff right here? The whole thing bends. So if you do hit something hard, at least it'll be a little forgiving. That's kind of cool. Okay, so I got this piece put together.
And I'm gonna mount it into the back of the amplifier. It's gonna look something like that. All right, there's what it looks like. All wired up. It looks funny, but hey, it's gonna give me cell phone coverage, cell service. So now we got one more wire to run here, follow back, and droop behind and secure behind the fridge. All right, just gonna fill up these holes now that I got this all screwed back in. This will all look pretty once it settles. Yep, and we're all wired up. Going to this, it's time to move
on inside.
All right, so following the directions, I'm gonna do a little test here and set it up exactly as they want me to set it up to make sure. So the main interior antenna is more than 4 feet away from the other antenna outside, right about there, up there. And then the second external antenna currently right now, of course I'm gonna have to put this through the wall and everything, is 13 feet away, right there.
This is the only cell booster system I know that has two antennas. Now, it does say in there that it's optional to have the second one. I personally don't think I'm gonna need it, but I'm gonna test it just to see how much of a difference it makes, because inside the RV, I mean, it's a small RV, right? And everything is centrally located right here in this room.
My smart TV, my PS4, my hotspot device, which gives me my internet, my cell phone, I'm either gonna be sitting there or sitting here at the couch with Jax.
So I personally don't know if the second antenna is needed in every single application, but before we do anything, let's see what the internet is like here. I'm gonna do a speed test app test on the Verizon service that's here and just kind of see where we're at. It's not horrible service here, but still, I'd like to see some kind of a change. Now remember, this system is not gonna grab any kind of a cell signal out of nowhere. It has to amplify what's there. So to a certain extent, you're only gonna get so high anyway. But it's the signal strength. That's what we're improving. So if we have a really weak signal with only one bar of Verizon service way out there and I'm in the middle of nowhere, I can pull that in and change it to 3 or 4 bars, essentially. But still, we should see some kind of improvement. Okay, wait, I just read the manual. The secondary antenna that I tried up there is useless in this particular situation. It is only going to rebroadcast the same exact signal from the main antenna. And it says that you're gonna get a 20-foot radius around the antenna. So if you had a 40-foot RV, yeah, you'd want one at one end and the other at the other end. But in this circumstance, it's absolutely pointless to put a secondary antenna in the corner of the RV that's 12 feet away when I get 20 feet radius of that, including outside. So I definitely do want to keep the antenna close to the door so that when I'm outside, like in a chair or something, I'm also utilizing the amplified signal booster. But in this particular install, I do not need that secondary antenna inside.
All right, so we'll open up my speed test app here and first establish what we've got without the booster on. We are connected to a server in Cantby, Oregon. Yeah, we're really close to Oregon. But let's go ahead and see what... And you can also see up here, we are getting full bars of Verizon. So I don't know if this is the best place for this test anyway. It's not poor service, but let's at least establish where we're at right now without the booster. We'll let this ping our download and upload speeds. That's pretty incredibly good right there, it looks like. Oh, it came down. It was at like 22 there, but... it's gonna stop right about there. 14.6 megabits per second download speed, and our upload is struggling mightily here. Well, yeah. So upload here, officially, go ahead and stop whenever you want, 5.46. So remember those numbers, 14.6 download, 5.46 upload. I'm gonna reset this and turn the booster on. Okay, firing the app back up. It did change the server to Hillsboro, Oregon for some strange reason, but okay, go ahead and hit go. See if we can get some different numbers here. And
Okay. Well, it'll be a tick higher for downloads. We're going to finish off at, that's really high though, 20.1 megabits per second download. Yeah. Ooh. Upload is going to improve about 4 or 5 times. Check that out. 17.0 megabits per second upload speeds now. So download increased a little bit. Upload, wow.
This was not a perfect test. I do not base my whole review on this product based on speed tests from my Verizon service on my phone. Because what I talked about was this helping in different situations where I would only have had one bar or it said 3G. Maybe turning the booster on will change it to 4G LTE and a couple more bars of service out in those really remote places. And I've tested this theory with my other Wii Boost device because I had been to those campgrounds before with zero service. I get there with the booster and now I can upload a video. Now, having the download didn't come up very high, as you saw that with the booster, but you're only going to boost it so high. You know, it was already pretty good where it was at. Plus, we're not going straight from the cell phone to the tower. I'm asking the cell phone to go through the internal antenna and then the roof antenna and then that connecting. So there's a bunch of repeated stuff going on here, going to create a little bit of lag and it might slow you down. However, the upload, that's my business. That's my work. Uploading videos to YouTube. We just increased it 4 or 5 times with just installing this little booster right there, which is going to make uploads a snap, right? So yeah, I don't put a whole lot of weight on the actual speed test through there, but it is definitely going to help, and I will continue to show you how much this will help. Might get to some campgrounds here in the next few months, and I'll unplug the booster and show you. Look, no service. Plug it back in, I guess service. And then as for the second change install that we're working on, this is a project that I have put off in every RV I've had, and I don't know why necessarily, but I am not gonna go on this next winter without making this change. You guys remember I finally gave up on the Buddy heater system, those catalytic heaters. I moved on to the Camco Olympian Wave 8, which has been stored behind the passenger seat in its protective sleeve since February when I got it. But I am going to be using that catalytic heater this winter. That'll save, you know, blowing the air through the onboard furnace, save the batteries a little bit, no power required to power up those. But it is time to no longer have the propane tank on board, that unsightly, and the hose that runs the propane and everything. So I'll drop the RV off there tomorrow and cut back in and show you how that works out. In the meantime, I'm here at one of the Thousand Trails resorts that has a hot tub and a swimming pool, so I'm gonna enjoy it and enjoy my time with my kitty cat. So again, I'll cut back in tomorrow. All right, and here we are on a cloudy, overcast summer day. Coombs RV here, right off exit 107 in Olympia. They sell RVs, they repair RVs. They actually replaced a water heater in Tilly here several years ago. And they got propane conveniently right off the highway for $1.99. So I'm excited to see what they come up with tapping into the system so that I can make that heater right there work this winter. But anyway, I'm gonna be traveling with some friends over here that have come over to Washington State. And I'm gonna be having lunch with Motorhome Max, some YouTube friends of mine. And so yeah, I'll get back with you with the details later. Oh, come on. You were in the bathroom for 1 hour. It was only 1 hour, kitty. Stop being such a drama king. Your big toes and thumbses. Yeah. Yeah, big thank you to Coombs RV there. John getting me in last second. Really quick, I'll show you what they did. So behind my fridge, actually, we'll go outside. So on the back outside of the fridge here is the copper line, which is from the regulator from the propane tank. They just put in a T right here. And then this is going to be the propane line that now goes through the wall, and they resealed this back up. And then inside, again, underneath and behind the fridge comes in the propane. And here we have a nice quick connect right there with its own little shutoff valve right there. So we store the heater in the summertime, and when we want to use it, I bring it back out. There's our quick connect male. I can probably even do this one-handed into the female port there. Turn it on. We have regulated propane going into that, and we still have some room to kind of maneuver it or aim it around depending on where I want it exactly. Or I could mount it here. You do have to have 24 inches of clearance around it. I do have that right here. I could wall mount that without the feet, but
I kind of like the versatility of aiming it towards the couch and recliner area or changing it to the bed.
Of course, with temperatures right now still kind of warm, it is much too early to even talk about heat right now. So I'm just really thankful that I got it taken care of and that the awesome staff there at Coombs RV really took care of me today.
So we'll unhook this, put the cover back on, and wait till it gets cold again.
But also, that quick connect right there could be used for other things. I could then run a cord, or hose, I guess you'd call it a hose, outside to a barbecue grill or a camping fire stove that I used to have in one of my RVs. But yeah, awesome. Last project of the day before we head on south again. Miranda's getting an oil change. One more. Believe it or not, I have put on 3,200 miles in Washington State just his last 2 months here in the summertime. So people say, well, you went to Washington and then you're just not doing anything. 3,200 miles and a new oil change later. Remember, I got my oil change done as soon as I got back here as well. So we'll get that done. Jackson's going to monitor everything. And then my next video, we'll be back on the road, guys. So take care. Bye-bye.